When I'm done with this, yes, I can do anything else possibly. Then I was like King of Haight-Ashbury in 65, right? And when Jerry and I started like the Rainbow People and Green Power and that. And like, I don't know, maybe that's why Jim called me that King of Venice too, you know, when I came here, is because I was King of Haight-Ashbury in 65, you know, 1965. So the spirit is able to, is not limited, you know, to time and space, you know. You know what I mean, man? So now they're gonna do my life story. Who could do my life story, man? My life story runs like a fairy tale. There's no way anybody can do it, I don't think. It's funny, but it is funny, you know? Because my whole life is kind of like that. I mean, I did a lot of famous stuff. It's a myth now that nobody can even believe I did, you know? And I can't even believe I did it because I did it in a blackout, but the films are telling on me, right? You know what I mean, man?
My Doors used to live there. I partied with them. They were like, you know, they had like, there was like dirt out here, and you know, if you had your sleeping bag or whatever, you crashed out of, you know, along the outside.
I didn't tell you about that, right? When I first came to Venice, right? It was like 69, and you know where the Kiss Radio building is? The Doors were living there, and there was like a record party going on, and somebody came out of the party and invited me into the party. Like I blinked and I'm upstairs there 6 months later, but I don't know it's been 6 months later. I'm telling you, this really happened. I'm thinking to myself when I'm looking in this, I'm in this room and I got all these guitars and money and clothes and everything's all, and I'm wondering who's this, it's my stuff, but I don't remember it anymore. I came out of the blackout. Huh? Now is that crazy or what? I, you know, but people see the musical side of me and they see that I wrote a big song for Jimi Hendrix, right? I wrote Purple Haze. When I was a kid, Janice asked me to write that down, or, you know, but like I sang it and they were both in the club and I wrote it down for her. She asked me to write it down as I was leaving. You know what somebody told me? They said, man, you should have stayed in the blackout. Is that funny or what? You know? How am I gonna stay in the blackout, you know? Yeah, how would I know I was in the blackout is what I'm saying, you know? There's a movie I did like that, a movie with George C. Scott. Hey, I talked him off the wagon. George C. Scott, and I did a movie with him called Hardcore in a blackout.
Blackout?
Out again, you know? I feel like I'm going somewhere, but I'm blacked out. And I hear this voice way off in the distance later saying, a long time later, it seems like, oh yes, I intend to do other movies, but I just got married and I'd like to be alone with my wife. I come out of the blackout and it's me saying this in an interview with this woman. Oh, man. Oh, you know what I mean? That kind of stuff, huh?